You know what's cool about this museum?
What's that?
They have 24 lines of craft beer.
It's the best museum ever.
Ever, ever.
You have the component of the arts and crafts movement. It was a revolt against industrialization and the decorative arts. It was a return from manufactured products to handmade craftsmanship, which we thought went along super well with craft beer.
Welcome back to the Happy Hour, guys, and welcome back to our series featuring the Arts and Crafts Beer Parlor, 26 West 8th Street in New York City's West Village.
Oh, by the way, my name's Jimmy Ludwig.
My name is Mark Aldrich.
And guess what? They don't just pay lip service to the arts in this incredible craft beer bar. They have a very robust arts program and, well...
I mean, a lot of places will put up on the walls some local artists or some photography or something like that. They take it to a new level.
What was that going to be? Well, you can't call yourself Arts and Crafts without having real arts and crafts.
Yeah.
So we went from installing a $30,000 beer tap system to custom making the wallpaper on the wall, which is a Bradbury and Bradbury art wallpaper, commonly referred to as one of Frank Lloyd Wright's favorite wallpapers. Well, the only problem is it's not like they keep that in stock. So we had to have the wallpaper custom made, and unfortunately I didn't tell Donna exactly how much that cost until it came in. But I'm on. So between the oil wood bronze and all of the fixtures, what you see on the foot rail, on the bar, the wood cladding on the walls, this is very much indicative of the arts and crafts style.
The main focus here, obviously, people come in, they want to enjoy cold beer, but the art program is also an important part of what we do.
In the amount of time that we've been open, we've gone through over 150 different types of beer in 4 months. It's kind of extraordinary. So to keep the atmosphere as dynamic as the board and everything that happens from our beverage program.
They feature a unique artist on a rotating basis. This is Victoria de Almeida, and her artwork is very distinctive, beautiful. I love this. I'd hang out with those guys anytime.
I like the monks.
Through this program, I think, what they've acknowledged is that craft beer is an art in and of itself. Mm-hmm. So they're marrying two different art forms.
We are a living gallery. We function as any art gallery does. Everything that is on the wall is for sale, and every month we do have a new artist.
This month, as you can see, it's got a little bit of a southwestern flair.
Really cool.
Right?
Yeah.
Victoria de Almeida from New Mexico. She's an award-winning artist in this style of New Mexican folk art.
We have four of her originals, a number of giclées, and there are prints also available.
So basically people just, they'll sit here and they'll be like, I really love that painting. They come to you, you contact her.
Yep.
And then...
And we have a price list, so we try to negotiate on behalf of the artist, but at the end of the day, it's their work, it's not ours. So.
Yeah.
We defer to them, but we try to facilitate it, make it as easy as possible on the customers if they find something they really want to take home.
That is super cool.
And don't kid yourself, these guys don't just know a lot about beer, they know a lot about art.
But she also does get caught up on certain things, like Oscar Wilde. She has a fascination with Oscar Wilde. This is probably the premier painting in her collection. There are two giclées of it, and if you don't know what a giclée is, it's basically a reproduction like a lithograph or a serigraph, but it's injected onto canvas, so it's like having a real painting.
And how about this? In terms of creating an art movement, they couldn't have chosen a better location.
This was really a very famous epicenter. Our proximity to the New York Studio School for Drawing, Painting, and Sculpture next door, and even for the Beat Poets, a hotel down the street, you know, Allen Ginsberg almost was assassinated in front of it.
What?
Jack Kerouac, rather, finished three of his books in that hotel, the Marlton. So the street was very famous. I think it lost its way in the 70s and the 80s. And I think there is a resurgence in 8th Street.
So put aside for the moment how much you love craft beer, and we know that is extremely difficult to do. There are so many other reasons to make an evening of it at Arts and Crafts. Of course, there's the art program. There's the fact that they're an extremely green company. It's the community that they build, and it goes on and on and on.
So keep an eye out for the Arts and Craft Beer Parlor chalkboard.
Chalkboard!
Follow your feet to beer heaven. 5 steps, worth it for 24 beer lines.
Five steps off street level. You really shouldn't miss it.
Clearly a labor of love.
For us in beer, we haven't found the perfect beer, but we're trying.